प्रॉब्लम नंबर वन, सॉल्व पी स्क्वायर प्लस पी क्यू इक्वल टू जेड स्क्वायर. फर्स्ट राइट डाउन द गिवन इक्वेशन. गिवन दैट राइट डाउन द गिवन इक्वेशन पी स्क्वायर प्लस पी क्यू equal to z square. So this is of the form f of zp q is equal to 0. Form f of zp q is equal to 0. If you can write p square pq in the right hand side or z square in the left hand side, this must be in the form f of z p q. There is no x y z appears explicitly. For this equation, to solve this equation, we have to assume the solution as explained earlier. Let z is equal to f of x plus a y. Say this is equation number 2. Be the solution of the equation. Be the solution of the given equation. Then put x plus ay is equal to u. Say this is equation number 3. Then equation 2 becomes z is equal to f of u. Say this is equation number 4. Therefore, we have seen in the earlier procedure, by differentiating equation 3, equation 4 partially with respect to x and y, we get p is equal to dz by du, q is equal to dz by du. So p is equal to dz by du, q is equal to a into dz by du. We can directly the values of p and q in equation number 1. Therefore, substituting the values of p is equal to dz by du and q is equal to a into dz by du in equation 1, we get given equation 1 is p square plus pq is equal to z square. Therefore, p dz by du plus pq dz by du into q. Q means a into dz by du is equal to z square. Therefore, so here p square means dz by du whole square. Therefore here dz by du whole square, dz by du into dz by du, here also dz by du whole square. Therefore we can take this dz by du whole square as a common factor. Dz by du whole square, that becomes here 1 plus here a equal to z square. Therefore, dz by du whole square is equal to z square by 1 plus a. Therefore, dz by du is equal to square root of z square by square root of a. Therefore, we can use plus or minus, no problem. Dz by du is equal to z by root of a 1 plus a. Therefore, this can be written as by using variables and separables. Separate the variables. Z variables one side, u variables other side. By cross multiplication, this can be written as 1 by z into dz is equal to 1 by root of 1 plus a into du. Or otherwise, you can write 1 plus u here also. Therefore, if you want to write in the left hand side 1 plus a, you can write no problem, nothing wrong. Therefore, integrating on both sides. Now, integrating on both sides, we get 1 by z dz is equal to 1 by root of square root of 1 plus a is a constant to du. Therefore, 1 by z, this is log z, is equal to 1 by root of square root of 1 plus a into integration of 1 with respect to u is u plus constant of integration b. Therefore, log z is equal to u means x plus ay by square root of 1 plus a plus b. Therefore, this is the complete solution for the given problem, given equation, as it contains two independent variables x and y, two arbitrary constants a and b. Therefore, it is complete integral, which is the complete integral of the given equation 1. Where a and b are arbitrary constants. Problem number 2. Solve z is equal to p square plus q square. Now write down the given equation. Given that z is equal to p square plus q square, say this is equation number 1. This is of the form f of z comma p comma q is equal to 0. This can be written as z minus p square minus q square is equal to 0. Therefore, this is of the form f of z p q. F of z p q p means it should contain only the terms involving z, p and q, but not the variables x and y. Therefore, to solve this equation, let us assume that the solution as explained in the method of solution, procedure of the solution, let z is equal to f of x plus ay be the solution of the given equation. Let z is equal to f of x plus ay. Say this is equation number 2. Be the solution of the given equation 1. Put x plus ay is equal to u. Say this is equation number 3. Then equation 2 becomes z is equal to f of u. This is equation number 4. Therefore, partially differentiating 4 with respect to x and y, we get the values of p and q. Then p is equal to dz by du, as explained in the procedure I already used in the previous problem also. Q is equal to a into dz by du. Now substituting the values of p and q in equation number 1. Now substituting the values of p and q in equation 1, we get equation 1 is z is equal to p square plus q square. Substitute the values of p and q. P square plus q square, z is equal to p square, that means dz by du whole square, q a into dz by du whole square. Therefore, again here dz by du whole square is a common factor. 1 plus a square into dz by du whole square. Therefore, this can be written as z by 1 plus a square equal to dz by du whole square. Therefore, this can be written as dz by du is equal to square root of z by square root of 1 plus a square by variables and separables. Separate the variables, z variables one side, u variables another side. 1 by cross multiplication, 1 by root z into square root of 1 plus a square into dz is equal to du. Therefore, integrating on both sides, as explained in the previous problem, you can keep one root of 1 plus a square either in the right hand side or left hand side, nothing wrong. Therefore, 1 plus a square, square root of 1 plus a square is a constant. 1 by root z, that can be written as z power minus 1 by 2 into dz is equal to integration of 1 du. Z power 1 by 2, square root means we are writing in the numerator. So power becomes a minus, plus power becomes minus 1 by 2. Therefore, square root of 1 plus a square into integration of z power minus 1 by 2, that is z power minus 1 by 2 plus 1 by minus 1 by 2 plus 1 is equal to integration of u 1 with respect to u, that is u plus constant of integration is b. Therefore, square root of 1 plus a square into z power minus 1 by 2 plus 1 z power 1 by 2 divided by 1 by 2 is equal to u. U means x plus ay plus b from equation number 2, since u is equal to x plus ay. Equation number 3. From equation number 3. Therefore, by again simplifying, we will get 2 into square root of 1 plus a square into square root of z is equal to x plus ay plus b. Therefore, squaring on both sides, this is 4 into 1 plus a square into z is equal to x plus ay plus b whole square. Therefore, z is equal to x plus ay plus b whole square by 4 into 1 plus a square, which is the complete integral as it contains two independent variables x and y, two arbitrary constants a and b, therefore, which is the complete integral of the given equation. Complete integral of the given equation. Problem number 3. Solve p into 1 plus q is equal to q into z. Write down the given equation. Given that p into 1 plus q is equal to qz, say this is equation number 1. This is of the form f of pq, zpq is equal to 0. There is no x, y, z explicitly. So, therefore, this is of the form f of z, p, q. For this type of equations, let z is equal to f of x plus a, y. Say this is equation number 2. Be the solution of the given equation. One. Then put x plus ay is equal to u. Say this is equation number 3. Then equation 2 becomes z z is equal to f of u. This is equation number 4. Therefore, by partially differentiating 4, we can get p is equal to dz by du as explained in the procedure, and q is equal to a into dz by du. Now, substitute the values of p and q in equation number 1, that is in the given equation. Substituting the values of p and q in equation 1, we get equation 1 is p into 1 plus q is equal to qz. You can substitute the values of p and q in this equation. P dz by du into 1 plus q a into dz by du is equal to q a into dz by du into z. Therefore, here dz by du gets cancelled. Therefore, this can be written as 1 plus a into dz by du is equal to z, a into z. Therefore, we can write 1 in the right hand side, a into dz by du is equal to az minus 1. Again, a you write in the right hand side, that is dz by du is equal to az minus 1 by a. Dz by du is equal to az minus 1 by a. Therefore, this can be written as az by a minus 1 by a gets cancelled. Z minus 1 by a. This is dz by du. By variables and separables, this is the ordinary differential equation. Therefore, separating the variables. Therefore, z variables one side and u variables other side by cross multiplication du. Therefore, integrating on both sides, we get integration of 1 by z minus 1 by a dz equal to integration of 1 du. Therefore, this is 1 by z minus 1 by a. Therefore, integration of 1 by z minus 1 by a can be written as log of z minus 1 by a is equal to integration of 1 with respect to u, that is u, plus constant of integration. Therefore, log of z minus 1 by a is equal to u, that is x plus ay, plus constant of integration. Therefore, which is the complete integral, as it contains x and y, two independent variables, a and b, two arbitrary constants.